There are two versions of the M272V configuration engine on the market, a port injection version and a direct injection version. In this program, we'll refer to the port injection version as the KE engine and the direct injection version as the DE engine. This program will focus on the special features of the DE version. Chapter 1 looks at some of the basic features which distinguish the DE version from the KE version. These include the mechanical engine systems, the control unit, a new bus, and the coolant circuits. Let's begin with the shape of the pistons. On the KE, the piston crown is flat. By comparison, the piston crown on the DE has been raised by the addition of ring-shaped material. The additional material makes the combustion chamber smaller and consequently increases compression. The layout of the components in the cylinder head is also different. On the KE engine, the spark plug is positioned centrally in the cylinder, whilst the injector is on the side. On the DE engine, the center position is occupied by the injector. This benefits the new spray-guided combustion process. The spark plug has been moved to the exhaust side and is installed at an angle so that the spark plug's overhead electrode is immersed precisely into the edge of the injection spray cone. Now let's have a look at the engine electronics control unit. On the DE engine, it is exposed to higher levels of heat. The output stages of the piezo fuel injectors incorporated into the control unit, for example, generate an operating voltage of up to 160 volts. To dissipate the heat, the ME control unit is therefore liquid cooled. On the DE engine, the control unit must also actuate a number of additional components. These are the actuator motors for external exhaust gas recirculation, the shut-off valve for the low temperature cooling system, the pressure regulating valve, and the quantity control valve of the fuel system's high pressure circuit. The DE engine has an additional sensor data bus, CAN-S, which is controlled by the ME control unit. Also using the bus, in addition to the ME and fuel pump control units, are the two nitrogen oxide sensors with integral control units. The sensors are required for stratified charge operation. The additional CAN-S bus only links these four bus users and, amongst other things, permits diagnosis of the fuel pump control unit. The cooling system on the DE is somewhat more complex than on the KE. Let's start with the conventional coolant circuit, as found on the KE engine. The heated coolant flows from the engine to the radiator, where it is cooled. The coolant is pumped back to the engine by the coolant pump. The triple plate thermostat ensures precise heat management. Depending on requirements, the heating system can be connected to or disconnected from the coolant circuit via a shut-off valve. The DE engine variant has two additional coolant circuits. Both can be connected and disconnected by means of a common shut-off valve. Let's look first at the coolant circuit for external exhaust gas recirculation. Its task is to cool some of the components that are particularly sensitive to heat. These are the two actuator motors for regulating the amount of recirculated exhaust gas, and the connecting pipe through which the recirculated exhaust gases flow back to the intake pipe. The DE engine also has another circuit, the low temperature coolant circuit. This helps to reduce the coolant temperature even further by means of a second radiator. The low temperature coolant circuit is used to cool the engine control unit and the fuel. The shut-off valve, shared by the two additional coolant circuits, is map-controlled. The critical parameters are the fuel temperature, the temperature of the engine control unit, and the exhaust gas recirculation rate.